It's Professor Dave. Let's complete the square.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned how to solve polynomials by factoring. But not all polynomials can be factored, so we definitely need a few other techniques. One technique that will always work is called completing the square. So let's see how that works now. First, consider the following polynomial, x squared plus 2x plus 1. This can be factored, but furthermore, it can be factored into two identical binomials. The factors of 1 are 1 and 1, or negative 1 and negative 1, and the positive 1s do indeed add up to 2, so we can factor this into x plus 1 times x plus 1. Anything times itself is by definition that thing squared, so we can also express this as x plus 1 quantity squared. If this were equal to 0, the solution is very simple. It's just negative 1, because that's the value for x that will make this equal to 0. So the original polynomial must be a perfect square, since it can be generated by squaring this binomial, just like how 4 is a perfect square because it's 2 squared. This kind of thinking comes in handy for certain polynomials, because while they might not factor, we can deliberately add some term to the expression that will manufacture a polynomial that is a perfect square, thus allowing us to express it as the square of a binomial and making it easy to solve. This will make more sense with an example. Let's say we have x squared plus 2x minus 6 equals 0. If we find the factors of negative 6, which are combinations of 1 and 6 or 2 and 3, we find that there is no way to add any pair of factors together to get positive 2, so we can't factor this polynomial. But let's do a little trick. Let's add 6 to both sides, bringing the 6 to the other side. Earlier we saw that x squared plus 2x plus 1 is a perfect square. So what if we now add 1 so that we suddenly do have a perfect square polynomial, in essence, completing the square? Well, whatever we do, we have to do it to both sides, so we end up with x squared plus 2x plus 1 equals 7. The reason this is useful is that we can now express the left side as x plus 1 quantity squared. From here, it's not very hard to solve. We have an exponent of 2, so we take the square root of both sides. That gives us x plus 1 equals plus or minus root 7. Remember that when taking the square root of a number, we get two answers, since both of these square to give 7. Now we subtract 1 to solve for x, and the right side can now be expressed as two values, either root 7 minus 1 or negative root 7 minus 1. While these are not as aesthetically pleasing as integers, they are indeed the two solutions to this polynomial. Let's try another. Say we have x squared plus 6x minus 2 equals 0. Once again, we would quickly see that this can't be factored, so let's bring 2 to the other side. Now, to complete the square, all we do is take this coefficient of x, in this case 6, and we must cut it in half and then square it. 6 divided by 2 is 3, and then we square that to get 9. We add 9 to both sides to complete the square, leaving us with this expression. The reason we do this is because we need a c term with factors that multiply to give c and add to give b. But since it's a perfect square, the factors must be identical, so that factor must be the square root of c, and at the same time add to itself, or double, to give b. So when doing these problems, just cut the x coefficient in half to get the factor that will go in the binomial, and then square it to get the c term you must add to both sides. And that's all you need to worry about. Now we do have a perfect square, so we get x plus 3 quantity squared equals 11. Take the square root and subtract 3, and we get x equals root 11 minus 3, or negative root 11 minus 3. Let's do just one more. 3x squared plus 15x minus 8 equals 0. Once again, we bring 8 to the other side, but now we have something trickier on the left. The best thing to do when there is a coefficient on the x squared term is to divide everything by that coefficient. You may end up with fractions, but this is definitely the easiest way to go, even if that's the case. So let's divide everything by 3. We will get x squared plus 5x equals 8/3. Now we can complete the square. With 5, it may seem messy because cutting in half gives 5/2, which then squares to give 25/4. But if that's what we get, then that's what we have to work with. We add that to the right side as well, find the least common denominator, which is 12, and convert these fractions to 32/12 and 75/12 so that we can add them together to get 107/12. Now we factor the left side to get x plus 5/2 quantity squared. Remember, when we cut that initial b term in half before we square it, that's the number that will end up in the resulting binomial. Then, just like the other examples, we take the square root of both sides and subtract 5/2, which will allow us to express the two solutions for x, being sure to simplify radical expressions if applicable. Don't worry if the answers look unappealing. If that's what we get, then that's what it is, and solutions won't always be neat and tidy. With this new technique under our belts, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.